Today, the objective is instead of solving for missing sides, today we're using SOHCAHTOA to solve for missing angles. A little bit of a different process, very similar though. Either way, you need to know those trig functions. You need to know which ones to use when. We'll go through these two problems, the example for you first, and then we'll try some together. I kind of broke it down into steps for you, hoping that would make it clear what to do. In this one, we're solving, I'm scratching out y there and x there. This is the same triangle. They just split it up into solving for x here and solving for y here. First step of solving for this angle x is setting up a trig ratio involving your missing angle. So here they noticed, I'm gonna write step one, ratio. You're setting up this ratio with our missing angle in it. They noticed, okay, well, I am given 6 and I'm given 15. 6 is the adjacent, 15 is the hypotenuse. So that means I have to do the cosine of x because those are the only two numbers I'm given. Cosine of x, adjacent 6 over 15. Next is the tricky part. You have to isolate this x. We have a cosine attached to it. We need to get rid of that because that's how you solve for things. You isolate it. Step two, isolate. I'm going to go to another page just to clarify step two because it's super important that you understand what's going on. Isolate variable. So in the first step, we had cosine of x equaling 6 over 15. How would you maybe think to isolate x? Just looking at it and what we've done, yeah. Ascend it over. Okay, so that's not completely legit. I've seen a lot of people try this business. Don't write this down because it is not right. This is not a thing either. You can't do that. No way. What we can do though. Oh, yes. Let's hear it. Oh, yes. That is exactly what you do. The inverse cosine. So over there in our warm-up, we had 2 times x equals 4. We decided that if something is being multiplied, we're going to do the inverse operation. Multiplication was happening, we divided. The inverse operation for when you have the cosine of an angle would be to multiply both sides by the inverse cosine. And so you do the inverse cosine of one side, you have to do it to the other side. So I'm gonna rewrite that so it's prettier. These two cancel out. You're left with x equals cosine inverse of the ratio you had on that side. That is how you isolate that x. That is super important. It works with sine and tangent also. Inverse of sine. Both sides, inverse tan, both sides. Moving back. So, step two, that's what they did here. They isolated. That's why we have this inverse cosine, because they did it to both sides. We got rid of the cosine on this side by doing that, and now you have cosine inverse of 6 over 15. Step three, final step, calculate. Grab your calculators. Let's check this. Let's see if they did it right. I'll pull up my calculator too to make sure. Whoa. Well, so to do an inverse of cosine, you do second and hit the cosine button. That's the cosine inverse of 6 divided by 15. 66.421. Yep. Did we get that? Is it clear how to type it into the calculator? Okie dokie, let's find our... Okay, step three, calculate. We have our angle. We are good to go, we found x. Now I'm gonna jump over here and talk you through finding y. First step, again, step one, setting up that ratio. We realize we have something opposite of our angle, we realize we have the hypotenuse. That leaves us with sine. We have to use sine. If we tried to use cosine, we'd have adjacent over hypotenuse, but we don't even have a value for adjacent, so we can't use it. That's why we're stuck using sine. Again, to isolate the y, we're applying our inverse function to both sides. Our inverse of sine is sine inverse, obviously. And that's why we have y isolated equals sine inverse of our ratio. And if you wouldn't mind, could you check this last one on the calculator? Make sure you get 23.578 or 24 degrees. Looking for head nods. Yes, yes, we're good. Okay. Now yesterday, at the end of doing our example together, I mentioned something about checking your work. Yesterday, with the missing sides, how did I ask you to check your work? Pythagorean theorem, and that's a solid way to know for sure that you will get it correct. Today, we have something very similar. Do you remember this lovely fact that the three angles in a triangle have to add up to 180? And we know that this one is 90, right? That's the only way we can use these trig functions, is if there's one 90 degree angle. So that leaves us with 90 degrees left. That's all that there can be. And so their check here is just showing you that the two angles we found equal 90, because that would mean that the whole triangle adds up to 180. You could do x plus y plus 90 and see if it equals 180. They just chose to deduce the fact that these two will have to add up to 90 itself. You can do either way, but once again, that's a really solid way for you to check your own work. Oh, let's try some. This is number one and number two on in your packet. Step one for number one, we'll solve for x first. Step one for number one, we have to find a trig ratio that includes our x. Does anyone have any ideas? We don't have all three sides, so we can't just use whatever we want. We need to figure out what trig ratio applies here. Look, according to the position of x, where our numbers are. Yeah, Chase. Sine of x equals opposite over hypotenuse. We have our opposite. We travel all the way across. Over hypotenuse is 12. Very good. Step two. Let's isolate x. How do we isolate x? Sine inverse, both sides. Eliminates the sine on this side. We have sine inverse of 6 over 12. Step 3, calculate. Make sure you type it in correctly. Use second sine, that'll give you sine inverse, of 6 over 12. Answer, anyone? 30 degrees, that is what I got. 30 degrees, very nice. Let's scroll down a bit, switch it up. Y, we are looking for y now. Step one, what trig ratio works now? It's in a different position, we have different values. Yes. The cosine, you are correct. Cosine of y equals, we have the adjacent now that we're in a different position. Cosine of y equals 6 over 12. Step two, isolate our y value. Anyone? Well, we just jumped to the answer I heard. No, it's okay. That's good. You sound like you're understanding it. So you would do the cosine inverse of both sides. So you isolated y, and you have cosine inverse of 6 over 12, and who is it that said the answer? Because I think I like that. Dan? Go ahead. 60. Well, whoever it was, they were right. So that's good. If you want to just show a quick check, you could do x plus y plus 90, which is going to be 30 plus 60 plus 90, which is 180. We're good. Does that make sense to everyone? No confusion. Yeah? We're good? All right. Let's do number two. We'll start with x. What ratio goes with x for this one? Yeah, John? Tangent. Very good. Tangent of x. Yeah, we don't even have the hypotenuse. We couldn't even use sine or cosine. Tangent of x is 10 over 10. We isolate that by doing tangent inverse of both sides. That eliminates the tangent on the left side. We're left with tangent inverse of 10 over 10, or 1, on the right. We type it into the calculator. We get 45 degrees. Do we agree? Yep. Okay, very nice. 45 degrees. Okay. Oh, switch colors. Ratio for y. Anyone? The same thing. Yeah, we only have opposite and adjacent. That leaves us with tangent. Tangent of y, 10 over 10. Isolate that by multiplying by inverse tan, eliminating the tangent on the left, left with tangent inverse of 10 over 10 on the right. Should look pretty familiar. Y equals 45 degrees again. We see that x plus y equals 45 plus 45, which equals 90. It's exactly what we needed. Had 90 left to use, we used it up. We're good. So those are the only ones we're going to do together. You have the rest of the page to do for homework. So you can go ahead and get started on that, but I'm going to come around and pass out an exit slip. And there's just one and two over there. I just want to make sure you know how to do yesterday's skill and today's skill. So I'm going to pass around an exit slip for you to fill out. You don't have to redraw the picture or anything. Yes. Go ahead. I'm not sure I followed.
Let's say you're the sine of x.
Yes.
I mean,